Welcome back to another session of Minecraft 101, or if you prefer at this point, Minecraft 102. We've graduated from the simple stuff and now we're setting up for our enchanting table and enchanting room. The first step was to begin getting things for books, which we're working on above with agriculture. As you can see in a previous video, but right now we're mining for the things we need for an enchanting table. And as you can see, we have very fortunately come upon some diamond ore. You can preview review the earlier video where I talk about how to mine for diamond at level 11. That method has been successful and I found some diamond and some other goodies. What I'm hoping for here is for about 5 pieces of diamond. That's what I need. I'm going to need 2 pieces to go into the enchanting table itself. But before that, I'm going to need 3 pieces to go into a diamond pick so I can mine up the obsidian. Because obsidian can only be mined up with a diamond pick. Anyway, you may notice that I am digging very carefully around this diamond ore. When you first find diamond ore, you want to collect all of it. You don't want any of it to be destroyed in lava, right? So you want to dig around it very carefully because there could be lava under there. Usually you can hear lava bubbling and such, but not always. Sometimes lava can be sneaky, and we don't want to take chances. So I'm digging above, I'm digging below especially, and I'm really paying attention to what I'm doing, and I'm not touching that diamond until I've dug all around it. So we're doing a full excavation here. Also mining up some of that good coal, too, while I'm at it. A lot of times, you'll find diamond in the midst of other ore, so a lot of times there'll be iron ore and coal ore around the diamond. And that's what we see here, actually. So I'm getting that iron, and I'm also digging under that diamond. Now I'm just about ready to hit that top piece. I've cleared all around it. We're all clear. Okay, keep everything well lit as we go. It's looking good. Let's go ahead and take that first diamond here in a moment. It's ready. Clear these other pieces too. Here we go. Notice stone. The stone pick. I want to show you this. Wasn't successfully mining it. You need that iron pick. So, don't make the mistake of using your stone pick on the diamond ore. If you do, you'll lose that diamond. It won't give you any diamond. It'll just be destroyed. So, a gold pick, an iron pick, or another diamond pick can be used to mine up that diamond. But I am using the stone pick for now to excavate around that diamond. This is slow. I'm intentionally going slow. You want to be paranoid about your first diamond vein. There we go. Getting all around it. That's looking pretty good. Yeah. Switch up to that iron. That's what I brought it for. And look. 5 pieces of diamond. Perfect. Might as well go ahead and grab this iron ore while we're here. And I think I'll also, since we sort of messed up our pathway here at level 11, I want to maintain that on the other side because I'm actually going to keep, at some point, not now, I'm going to continue the mine that way. So I just want to get it set up for that so we know where we're at. We're looking good. It's a lucky area. Of course, it's all algorithms and patterns. It's not really luck, but hey, feels like luck. Pretty good now. Now we know where the path is back to level 11. Eventually I'll bridge over this part. Well, it's time to go back to our base. Running, running, running. Once we get back to base, the first thing we're going to do is craft our first diamond pick. And we're going to use that on the obsidian that we're going to pass right here. See that obsidian right there? Earlier we dropped some water on that lava to make that into obsidian. So we're going to mine that up. Now obsidian's special. If you use iron on it, if you use gold, use anything but diamond, obsidian won't mine up, it'll just be destroyed. So we have to have 5 pieces, the first 3. Go into our pick, just like usual, you have 2 sticks for the handle, only this time, you go, instead of using cobblestone or wood, you go across the top with diamond, voila, diamond pickaxe. Life is good. Now, I'm only going to use this diamond pick for this obsidian, and then I'm going to put it away, because I'm going to wait until I can enchant that pick. This is our first diamond pick. So I'm going to save a really good enchantment on it for you. Maybe a like a silk touch or a fortune 3, efficiency 4 pick, something like that. It'll just keep going and going. Might also throw unbreaking 3 on it. And it'll last a long, long time. That obsidian. We have those other 2 pieces of diamond put away. Why did I throw them in the chest? I threw them in the chest because if you have diamond on you, you don't take it back with you. You never know when you might die or fall into lava. There's no reason to lose that diamond if you die. I'm mining under this obsidian. A lot of times under obsidian, that first layer of lava was turned into obsidian, but a lot of times there's an underlying layer. If the lava was more than 1 deep, in this case right here, it's shallow, it was only 1 deep. But I'll bet you if you keep going, you'll find some depth there. Mining this up with the diamond pick, notice it takes a long time. It looks like it's not going to mine. It's just because obsidian is super hard. Mining it up. Let's go for piece number 2. We're going to need 4 pieces to form the base of the crafting table. 4 pieces of obsidian. Let's see what happens. Good. Mine up this piece of obsidian. Getting a little iron too. It's always nice. What is that? I think that'll be number 3. There's some monsters nearby, but they're behind the lava. Nah, watch this. See how that lava destroyed that piece of iron ore? Okay. I don't care if it destroyed a piece of iron ore, but if that were diamond, that would have been devastating at this point. You'd recover from it, but it would have been demoralizing. That was the word I was looking for. Wouldn't have been happy. Okay. Headed back upstairs. When I'm doing this video, I'm actually doing a voiceover after the fact on this one. Didn't realize my microphone was muted. I made the mistake of trying to craft enchanting table early. Okay, visiting the cattle for some reason. Can't remember why I did that back when I first created the video. Now, I have just about everything I need. Let's see. I have my 4 obsidian. Kind of clean it up. Let's see. and get the leather that we need. The way we're going to do that is whenever you kill, you always breed them first by right-clicking them with the wheat. Cows produce beef or steak, and they also produce leather. And if you click them, right-click them with a bucket, you can get milk. We're actually going to use that later for a very specific purpose. Okay, now that we've bred them up pretty well, that's how you make a sustainable farm. You breed and then you kill. Now it's time to begin the harvest. Time for these cattle to pay me back. It's time to pay the piper. Unfortunate for the cows, but that's life. Actually, it's kind of the opposite of life. Life for me. Okay, right click that minecart that I made to get out. See how that works? You can also use ladders to do the same thing, but I like the minecart approach. Okay, so we have leather. Leather's from the book. We're going to need one book to create the enchanting table. We're going to need a lot more books to create bookshelves for the enchanting room. Might as well cook some good steak. No need to live off of bread anymore if we're harvesting our cattle. They didn't die for nothing. Getting our stuff together. I'm going to start building it. And you'll notice that I forgot to get my book. So I got to go back and make that. But that's what the base will look like. So you get a preview. I'm a pretty good Minecrafter, but just in general, as a person, I am super absent-minded. Notice our sugarcane farm. It's producing. You might notice right there that there seems to be an odd row there growing. How could that be? If it requires water beside it, well, I put water underneath that grass layer. There's our paper. We need three paper. Then you combine three pieces of paper with one piece of leather for the spine, and you have yourself a book. Just leather-bound paper. Put it anywhere on there, and it'll work. Book. Just to show the different ways to do it. Okay, got a book. Now we're ready. Build the base of obsidian. Three across, one in the middle, like a pedestal shape. Two diamonds on either side. Just fit them into those little corners. Then at the tip top, you put the book, and voila. Enchanting table crafted. Did I call it a crafting table earlier? If I did, I meant to call it an enchanting table. Way harder and more expensive than a crafting table. Okay. Well, we have that set up. Oh. Here's some zombies growling at me right next to my base. Let's put that enchanting table away. Rest in the bed and pass the night. And that, my friends, is the first major step. Let's go ahead and grab this. We have an enchanting table. The next step from here is to create bookshelves. Enchanting tables draw their power from books. So if you don't have bookshelves around the enchanting table, you won't be able to use powerful enchantments to enchant books. So that's the next step, and that's going to involve a lot of tree farming and a lot of cattle farming. Anyway, until that time, I wish you the best and I wish you happy Minecrafting.